Everything has to do with everything. Let's say you woke up one day and the family photo you had on the mantle was slightly adjusted, or there's something in the background you hadn't noticed before and you didn't think it used to be that way. Or you notice that the bookmarks and the books that you've read are on a different page and you may not recall reading it that far. That may be a sign that you're now traversing the world of rabbits.
Begin invasion in 3, 2, 1.
Before I get into today's review, let me just throw out some buzzwords, see if I can get your attention and have you hop on this rabbit hole of a book that is rabbits. So there was a quote in the book that referenced the movie Donnie Darko. It just said, "The Venn diagram of people interested in rabbits and in Richard Kelly's sci-fi thriller from 2001 is essentially just a circle." Yes, this is very much a Donnie Darko-esque kind of book. It's also what you would get maybe if you take the Da Vinci Code and mix it in with, like, Black Mirror. Or if you take the Jim Carrey thriller movie, The Number 23, and Mr. Robot. Like, those are the kind of things we're talking about here. And if you're familiar with the Mandela effect is, the Mandela effect is like a shared remembrance of a thing that a lot of people just kind of agree, oh yeah, that used to be this way, but then in reality, it's different than how everyone else remembers it. The prime example of this is the Berenstain Bears. Everyone thinks it used to be the Berenstain Bears, but it's really the Berenstain Bears. And there's also a shared remembrance of people thinking that Sinbad was in a movie called Shazam back in the 90s. That movie doesn't exist. There are things like, you know, Curious George never had a tail. The Monopoly Man never had a monocle. Like, those are things that are shifts in a remembrance of things that people are like, yeah, I remember that, but then you really look into it and it's like, no, it really didn't happen. So if you've ever sat to yourself and thought about those Mandela effects and been like, you know, is it parallel universes? Like, if you are the kind of person who cracks open your brain a little bit and you think about those kind of things, definitely, absolutely, positively check out and read the book Rabbits by Terry Miles. It's right up the alley for those potential parallel universes. There's also mentions of the Bader-Meinhof phenomenon, which is frequency illusion. It is a cognitive bias in which, after noticing something for the first time, there's a tendency to notice it more often, leading someone to believe that it has a high frequency. It occurs when increased awareness of something creates the illusion that it is appearing more often. Put plainly, the frequency illusion is when a concept or thing you just found out about suddenly seems to crop up everywhere. Let's talk about the author Terry Miles. He's a novelist, a filmmaker, a podcaster, and the CEO and founder of Minnow Beats Whale, which is his production company for all of these podcasts. Terry Miles started Minnow Beats Whale to tell stories from darkly comic dramatic feature films to documentary and docudrama podcasts. Stories shape us, define us, teach us, and have the capacity to reveal truth and meaning, to shine a light on what it means to be human. These existential questions are at the heart of what we want to explore: mystery, energy, humanity, story. So that's kind of the mission statement behind the Minnow Beats Whale and Terry Miles. So Rabbit started initially as a podcast, and this book is a kind of spin-off story that exists in the same world. So what is Rabbits? Well, Rabbits is a mysterious alternate reality game that uses like our modern day world as a canvas for people to play. So there are no signups or accounts or creation to play Rabbits. The game kind of chooses you. So everything that you think that you see in your daily life that is a coincidence, or you kind of look at the clock right at 11:11 and say your Starbucks bill for the morning was also 11:11, something like that, like those are those synchronicities that mean that you might be a participant in Rabbits. So what if those coincidences are really rifts in the multiverse that are giving you a peek into an alternate reality, like the Mandela effect? Like, people think that, yes, there really is somehow along the line in these Mandela effect things, people remember these things so strongly that there's a conspiracy that the worlds have shifted into a parallel universe, or our timelines have split, where back in a different timeline it really was that way. And now in this timeline, it is not. So this book kind of just lays that on super thick. The book tells a story about our main character, Kay, in the Pacific Northwest, who gets kind of caught up in this game after overhearing it as part of her parents and her friends saying, oh, what if it's rabbits? Because rabbits is something that's you're not supposed to talk about. But throughout the book, Obviously, they tell everybody everything they know about it. And so I won't say too much about the plot of the book. Other than that, that's just the primary theme. Like, if you like that kind of stuff, those conspiracy theories, those unsolved mysteries, or if you're good at recognizing patterns and things, or if you're observing these synchronicities, and you want to kind of get into that world, then definitely check out Rabbits. Like, so I'm really a sucker for those type of stories. I thought this book was fantastic to scratch that itch of what if there are other powers in place here. This thing mentions a thing called Meacham Radiance, which is described as like the world exists on a thumbprint. And if you can find the grooves, you can kind of manipulate things, or if you can shortcut over the grooves of the thumbprint of the world, other things can start happening. Things will be remembered differently. Things will change in your physical reality because you've kind of traversed these different alternate timelines. Kind of like, you know, the show Sliders back in the day. So the story essentially was kind of action-packed. There are a lot of those happenstance coincidences that are, you know, plot devices, but really kind of interesting and neat. But I could see someone at the same time just kind of rolling their eyes like, oh, you dug up a receipt in a dumpster on the side of the road that stuck to your shoe, but that receipt references like the numerical digits of a longitude and latitude that references the back alley of the restaurant that's next door to your house. And in the restaurant alley, you see something that's painted on the wall, or there's a trap door, and you go down the trap door and it leads into seeing something, you know, that's kind of how this book plays out. So if you're not, if you can't suspend belief to the point where you can enjoy that kind of thing, then maybe pass. But if you really like that and you're kind of sucked into that X-Files feel and stringing these coincidences in to get an overview of the plot of the book, then yes, I would say read it. It was really a fun ride. The ending itself was just kind of a, you know, mediocre feel, but I think the way that the stories take place and kind of the references, there are real life references in here of things and science and other pop culture things that exist, very kind of Pacific Northwest feel to this whole thing, and I really enjoyed it, and I absolutely ate up most of this book. I want to thank Michael Knipp for turning me on to the world of Rabbits. He's the one who kind of got me into the podcast and eventually reading the book. I really enjoyed it. I really love this book and these kind of stories, so definitely I would recommend checking out Rabbits by Terry Miles, just to explore the world of the unknown and that something of a higher power may exist when traversing these radiance or these waves that flow through time. Then check out Rabbits by Terry Miles. I really loved it, and I hope you do too. Thanks for watching, everybody. Thanks for checking it out. I will see you next time. Bye-bye.